tonight. You should know that this is a record crowd this evening. Take a moment to look around upstairs. We're at capacity, over 800 people here tonight. All celebrating the talents of our Indiana General Assembly and also supporting Mental Health America of Indiana. It's a pleasure to be here tonight for this memorable event. As you know, this event is a benefit for Mental Health America of Indiana, and your support is crucial to the success of Mental Health America of Indiana's programs and services. We're going to have a lot of fun tonight, and we know that you will thoroughly enjoy what's in store for you this evening.
For years, many of us who work in the political arena have found the Indiana General Assembly to be entertaining, whether intentionally or not, and tonight, we will take that to new heights. We have great acts for you this year, so please go ahead and start with your salad and meal as we proceed through the program. As we enjoy the evening, remember that the true focus tonight is the people who are served by the advocacy and the services offered by Mental Health America of Indiana. Through your support, Mental Health America is better able to provide advocacy and direct services for adults and children with mental health and addictive disorders. With that in mind, you may have noticed all of the auction items that are lining the walls around the room where we are this evening. I encourage you to bid often and bid high on these great items, knowing that the proceeds will go to benefit the good works of Mental Health America of Indiana. Now I'd like to introduce you to our head table. I'll start down to my far right. Phil Terry, CEO of Monarch Beverage and the honorary dinner chair for this evening's event. Dr. Mark Bangs, senior medical advisor for Eli Lilly and Company and chair of the board of Mental Health America. Melissa McCaffrey, wife of Steve McCaffrey. Steve McCaffrey, president and CEO of Mental Health America of Indiana. Our MC tonight, who gave me the evil eye when I talked about entertaining events in the legislature, Speaker Brian Bosma. Next to the speaker is his wife, Cheryl. And our three judges. You've seen this guy, right? You remember him? I know it's been a while since he's been on TV. But Jim Shella, retired State House reporter. Gabby Gonzalez, weekend anchor for Fox 59. And Abdul Hakim Shabazz, author of Indy Politics and lawyer with Lewis and Wilkins. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, that our flag was still there. Oh, say to us that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
Ladies and gentlemen, that's Sergeant Chris Wilburn, IMPD's own opera singing police officer. Let's give another round of applause. Thank you, Sergeant Wilburn. In addition to the head table tonight, I'd also like to recognize some of the other dignitaries that we have with us. As I say your name, would you please stand and be recognized? I'd like to recognize Attorney General Curtis Hill, who will be performing tonight. Indiana Secretary of State Connie Larson. State Auditor Tara Klutz. The Director of the Department of Child Services, Terry Stigden. Secretary of FSSA, Dr. Jennifer Walthall, who will also be performing tonight. State Health Commissioner, Dr. Christina Box. Michael Gargano, FSSA, Deputy Secretary and Chief of Staff. Jim McClellan, Executive Director for Drug Prevention, Treatment, and Enforcement. Director of the Division of Mental Health and Addiction, Kevin Moore. Kylie Hope, Director of Division of Disability and Rehabilitative Services. Also, we'd like to welcome the Indiana legislators who are stars tonight. At this time, I'd like to ask all members of the Indiana General Assembly to please stand and be recognized. I'd now like to invite Steve McCaffrey, Mental Health America of Indiana CEO, to recognize one legislator in particular.
Thank you, Roger. Mr. Speaker, legislators and dignitaries tonight, Mental Health America and the state of Indiana are very fortunate to have the leadership that we see in this room that benefits the citizens of our state. But there's one individual who, in particular, has been a leader in the area of mental health and addiction, and in health generally, Chairman Charlie Brown. Charlie Brown will literally leave a legacy of laws that assure access to mental health services and medications, mental health parity, loan forgiveness for mental health professionals, of course, HIP, the smoking ban, and so many others. Over the years, Charlie has been the recipient of many Mental Health America of Indiana Legislator of the Year awards. We would like tonight, for the final time, to recognize Charlie Brown with Mental Health America of Indiana's Lifetime Achievement Award. Now, before I asked Charlie to the podium to present him with the award, I thought it was only fitting and important, really, to ask a previous recipient of Mental Health America's Lifetime Achievement Award, as well as Charlie's legislative partner, Senator Pat Miller, to help me with the presentation. Pat?
Hi, Charlie. Steve said I could say whatever I wanted to, and
I'll call you back from that a little bit.
Okay. Speaker says I can't do that, but I think most of you know that Charlie Brown and I have been very close friends for 3 decades working in the General Assembly together, and Charlie has learned not only to work across the aisle, he's learned to work across the hall. And most of you probably know I'm pretty conservative, and Charlie isn't. So I say that I'm so conservative and he's so liberal, we meet. And that's what we've been doing for over 30 years. And usually we sort of kid around a little bit with each other, but I feel like tonight's the night to be serious because Charlie Brown has been an exemplary legislator. He's truly been supportive of mental health in all kinds of ways. His heart is there to help those who are suffering with mental illness. I think Charlie's to be commended for that, and I congratulate you, Charlie, on receiving this award. I also congratulate you for deciding to retire. He's always followed in my footsteps. This time he's a couple of years behind. And also, you may or may not know, Charlie's going to run for a local office up in his community. So Charlie, I want to congratulate you on this award. I congratulate you on your retirement, and I wish you the very best in your future political endeavors.
Charlie, you want to come up to the podium? Mental Health America of Indiana would like to present the Lifetime Achievement Award with grateful recognition for your legislative leadership in mental health and addiction, Chairman Charlie Brown.
Thank you, Steve. Thank you, Patricia. Patricia only told you half of the story about our relationship.
What's the other
half? And I don't know where Ed Clear is, but Ed Clear has a version that I wouldn't tell you, Patricia.
Thank you.
This is just wonderful. They did not give me a time limit on this. But I promise you, I will do exactly as Elizabeth Taylor did with her last six husbands. I will not keep you long. This has been an unusual ride over three decades with Patricia Miller. Patricia is white, and as you can see, I'm black. Patricia is female, as you can see, and I'm male. Patricia is rich, and I'm poor.
Not true. That's not true.
But that has been our mantra through the years. And it has just been, no one can understand, even I, how we have kept partisan politics out of health issues through those three decades. And it has been a marvelous ride working with Patricia. Can I kiss you?
Sure, right there. Thank you.
Where is Kenzie?
Right there.
Oh, I should have asked your permission first, so is it you? he said have at it. but that isn't the funniest story of all. One of the funniest stories is one year before the interim study committee, Patricia was chairing that year, and so I went into her office, and she happened to be talking to Larry Borst on the phone. And she said, Charlie, this is Larry on the phone. Say a few words to Larry. I got on the phone with Larry. We chatted for a few minutes, and then he said, Charlie, do you and Pat have a thing going on? I don't know where Larry pulled that from, but I do love her. I do love her.
That's mutual.
And Patricia loves the fact that most of the lobbyists that come in to see her, they would quiver because they were afraid of her. I mean, she was sincere about health issues and would not take any of the, I can't say that though, can I? She wouldn't take any of the nonsense that many of the lobbyists brought to her, and she wanted it to be above board, quality, et cetera. this is my award, but I'm here to just honor my lifelong friend, Patricia Miller. And I share this with her, even though she received it last year, and want her to know that I will love her forever.
It's mutual, Charlie. It's mutual.
Thank you all very much.
Thanks. That was so nice.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Mark Bangs. It's my pleasure to serve as chair of the board for Mental Health of America in Indiana. I feel so fortunate to be able to work with such a tremendous organization and individuals such as those here tonight. I, too, am happy to celebrate Chairman Brown's legacy. Mental Health America is the largest and oldest mental health advocacy organization in Indiana, dedicated to promoting mental health and preventing mental illness. I'm proud to say that we have a tremendous staff and a board of great stature. At this time, I'd like to ask our board, staff, and Indiana's affiliates to please stand and be recognized. Tonight, we will enjoy ourselves as we continue to fight for mental wellness. We all know people who fight this fight every day, but through your support of Hoosier Idol, we will be able to take the next step toward victory over mental illness and addictive disorders. We still have a long way to go, but thanks to the legislators, sponsors, and supporters in this room tonight, we've already made great progress. Thank you all. I'd also like to recognize our supporters and contributors for tonight's event. Please refer to your program for the listing of sponsors for 2018 Hoosier Idol. Of course, we want to especially thank Phil Terry of Monarch Beverages, who serves as our honorary dinner chair this year, sorry. Thank you, Phil.
Thank you, Mark, and also thank you, Phil, for making everyone just a little bit funnier tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a special guest this evening, backed by popular demand, a Hoosier Idol tradition. Elvis is in the building.
You look like an angel, walk like an angel, talk like an angel, but I got one. You're the devil in disguise. Oh yes you are, devil in disguise. Oh yes you are. You fool me with your kisses. You cheat and you lie. Heaven help me, I didn't see the devil in disguise. You look like an angel. Walk like an angel, talk like an angel, but I got one. You're the devil in disguise. Oh yes you are, devil in disguise. Oh yes you are. Walk like an angel, but I got wise. You're the devil in disguise. Oh yes you are, devil in disguise. Oh yes you are. Devil in disguise. Oh yes you are, devil in disguise.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Thank you.
Thank you, Elvis. Representative Bruce Borders, we appreciate having you here tonight.
We've got one more little love ballad here coming up. It's But I just want to share real quickly, though, after last year, Attorney General Curtis Hill and I can't go anywhere together. People keep mistaking us for twins. It's really, really pretty cool. But love to do a love ballad for you called Angel. I hope you enjoy it, the flip side of that.
Angel, with those angel eyes, come and take this earth boy up to paradise. Angel, come and hold me tight, never kissed an angel, let me kiss one tonight. If I said I love you, would I be speaking out of turn? I'm only human, but I'm willing to learn. Angel, make my wish come true. Let me be in heaven, here on earth with you. Angel, angel, never kissed an angel, let me kiss one tonight. If I said I love you, would I be speaking out of turn? I'm only human, but I'm willing to love. Angel, make my wish come true. Let me be in heaven, here on earth with you. Angel, angel, angel.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Appreciate that.
Thank you, Representative Borders. Ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy your dinner. We'll be back shortly as we all enjoy our fabulous entertainment from our own Indiana General Assembly. A reminder that the silent auction will end at 8:30 this evening, so please place your final bids as we select the 2018 Hoosier Idol. Enjoy your dinner. We'll be back shortly.
Are you having fun tonight? Okay. So if I could gather you up for a few moments. We just want to share a few thoughts before we start introducing some great entertainment. I was sort of lamenting with the judges up here that normally there's a great deal of material at this event because you have groups like Matt Whetstone and the Soggy Bottom Boys, Sheila Klinker and that little ukulele thing that she plays. Not that those aren't all talented folks, but we've got some really talented people tonight. But let's just talk. So I'm really acquainted with people not listening to me up front with alcohol on their breath. But I'm going to grab your attention back in the back, too. So I just want to talk for a second about why we're here tonight for Mental Health America, the Indiana chapter. And I've had a couple people say, why do you do this every year? And, of course, I'm charming and humorous, and that makes a lot of sense. Judges, be quiet. But also, I'm free to talk now because she passed away that I walked this walk for 45 years with a sister that struggled with schizophrenia. And she was an overcomer. She was independently, lived and worked, and she was actually a outstanding 27-year state employee. But we know firsthand, Cheryl and I and our family, and many of you know firsthand, the struggle that many families, almost every family we've come to find out, has with someone that's a friend or family member that struggles with mental health issues. So Mental Health America, well, of course, our family had resources and walked with my sister for years, but so many families don't, and Mental Health America is there for them. I was just talking with the director of the Boone County Mental Health Association and talking about the three deaths in Boone County this last week, three directly related to mental health issues. And this is just such an important cause. And it's one that previous generations didn't want to talk about. It was shameful. We couldn't even speak. When my sister passed away 2 years ago, my mom was still alive, and we couldn't even really speak of Jan's overcomer status because it would be so harmful to my mother. But our generations, the generations that are here now, we have to come forward and say this is an issue that we have to deal with, and one that we have to walk alongside with resources from folks like Mental Health America and the mental health professionals all around this state to make a difference. So thank you so much for being here this evening and supporting this great event tonight. Thanks to the legislators who are always willing to come here and put themselves way out there. We actually have some very talented, I'm a little disappointed because we have very talented groups tonight, so it gives very little material. So my wife told me it's not a nice night to be snarky, it's a night to be supportive. We'll see, Cheryl, how that goes. speaking of snarky, I would like to introduce two of our three snarky judges and then one of the most wonderful women in daytime television in my particular view. So first we have the former dean of the State House Press Corps, Norman Cox. Oh, I'm sorry. No. I'm so sorry. I made that mistake for so many years. It's Jim Shella is back again this year.
Thank you.
Jim is being played by Simon Cowell.
Yeah, let me. We've been commenting this head table is pretty wobbly. I'm starting to get a state fair vibe. Too soon?
Yeah, probably, but it's okay. And then at the opposite side, the only Muslim in the room, well, maybe not, but one of the few, my friend and the self-appointed commentator, political commentator, author, and now, very unfortunately, apparently the standards have been lowered, member of the Indiana Bar.
Damn Skippy, my brother.
Abdul Hakim Shabazz.
Here's all you folks got to remember. Get a cheat sheet subscription and reasonable doubt for a reasonable fee. That's all you need to know.
The purveyor of rumor and innuendo, and when you put it right in there and say this is all rumor and innuendo, I don't know. You can say whatever you want to say. And then daytime television, Indianapolis daytime television's most delightful individual, Gabby Gonzalez, the weekend anchor on Fox 59. Gabby, thanks for joining us.
Happy to be here.
You are literally the rose between two thorns. You know, it's kind of it's really true
tonight.
You gotta
bring the nice tonight because they're tough.
So I was like trying to get some information out of Gabby so I could say something about her, and she's like totally boring. Other than she was born in the Dominican Republic, so she is an island girl.
Caribbean, yeah.
To Florida and somehow to Indianapolis. So welcome. We love you here. Thank you. So we've got some very interesting acts this evening, and I think you'll actually be shocked by some of the folks here that are very talented, and we're just so pleased to have them here tonight. And before I start introducing one, really great thanks to Chris Wilburn and his wife Vic, who are here tonight, the IMPD officer that's the opera singer also. Our tradition here is always to have last year's winner first. So last year's winner was really awesome. And after his performance here, he got an invitation to go to America's Greatest Talent. So America's Got Talent, rather. So with that, I'd like to introduce Representative Earl Harris.
Think I wanna know ya. Hey, jungle love. That's it. So long.
All right, give it up. Give it up for Representative Earl Harris.
Woo!
All right, Earl, I got a question for you. We had, you're getting a lot of horns going there, so to speak. So we had a Republican-Democrat friendship dinner the other night, and you and I ended up doing karaoke with a group of others at Punch Bowl Social. And you picked, like, dirty songs. Does your mom know you picked these dirty songs? Because this was dirty.
Well, she knows that I'm a Prince fan, so yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, they were really dirty. Like, I started humming because I didn't want to say some of the words. So, I got another question for you. Can I ask why you picked Representative, who was that guy that came out with the mirror?
Well, Joe Taylor, otherwise known as Jerome.
I've never seen him before. Come out here, Representative Taylor, is that? So, do you speak? That's what I thought. It's exactly what I thought. Hey, you guys were great. Give it up for these guys.
It's my pleasure to present the 2017 Hoosier Idol Award to represent Earl Harris.
Thank you. All right. Earl, thank you. Jerome, thank you, too.
Do we get to comment on this act?
Well, yeah, I think so. Who said that? Was that Abdul or Jim?
That was me, Mr. Speaker.
All right, let's get a spot over there so we can see their face as they're saying these things. Yeah.
I just want to offer a suggestion. Can we get this guy to come back every year instead of Borders? Maybe you didn't notice, but I kneeled during the national anthem hoping that Borders would do a Mike Pence and go home.
Abdul, do you have anything to say after that?
I'm going to Wakanda. I'm leaving that one alone.
Yeah, taking a pass.
How are you doing, Gabby?
I'm going to take a pass on
okay,
this one.
Okay, that's good. Yep, I just was asking how you were doing. I knew you wouldn't want to say anything. Yeah. We got Curtis Hill. What more do you want, dude? Come on. All right, give it up one more time. Earl Harris. All right, the next group is, I'm going to say eclectic. So many of you know Campbell, Ricci, the policy analyst for the Senate Majority Campbell, or for caucus. We've got both Campbell, his father, Lewis, who's the executive director of the Arts Commission, Senator Mark Messmer, and others, is what my script says. So that's like Gilligan and the rest, right? Okay, so give it up for the Messmer Five.
Hey guys, how are you? So I take a minute to introduce everyone on stage. My father, the director of the Arts Commission, Lewis is on the keys. Senator Mark Messmer on the bass. My younger brother, Duncan, is on the drums, and my mother, Maggie, is on backup vocals. So it's mostly a family band, but Senator Messmer agreed to play with us, too. Whoa! Tell us. wasting on them. It's some season and lambs are on their own. Such a meaning. Are we all stars trying to light up the dark? Who are we? Just speckdust in the galaxy. Whoa. Careful turns into reality. Don't you dare let our best memories bring you sorrow. Yesterday I saw the land kiss a deer. Turn the page, maybe we'll find a brand new ending. We were dead, singing our tears and gown. Tell us the reason you was wasting on the young. It's unseason and lambs are on their own. Searching for meaning, but are we all stars trying to light up the dark? Woo-hoo-hoo. Wasting on the own. It's hunting season and this lamb is on their own. Searching for meaning, but are we all lost stars trying to light up the dark? Woo-hoo, I thought I saw you on that crowd. Woo-hoo-hoo.
Wow. Come on out. Holy cow. Come on out, man. My goodness. Yeah, you're good. Wow, Campbell. So, man, that was really, really cool. So how long have you been involved in music?
I started playing guitar when I was 9 years old. I suppose I've been singing for mostly forever, you know, just as long as you've been able to sing. So, yeah.
Wow, it was absolutely fantastic. So get your dad out here. Come out, Dad. And the others. So you got to be proud.
Oh, absolutely. I taught him everything he knows, though, but, you know.
It was just really awesome. All right, so I know you introduced earlier, but I'm going to make the others introduce themselves as well.
Okay, I'm the mom. So we do the, yeah, we do the genetically blended voices, so vocals are kind of our thing.
So who's responsible here, you or your husband?
Responsible for which?
For Campbell.
Well, you know, it, as you might understand, and I have taught biology at some point, it is a two-part sort of a thing that you have to do.
So I will sign a consent form here, and everybody else will sign a consent form, and we'd like to hear those details. Okay, so are you also a relative?
Yes, I'm the little brother.
My goodness, what a talented family. I don't know who you are. Hey.
I just feel fortunate to be asked to join the Ricci family band. These guys are awesome.
Wow, give it up for the Ricci family band. Wow, 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 wow. So I had to go back there. This is always embarrassing to say, how do you pronounce this? R-I-C-C-I. They're like all of them Richies, right? So they kind of knew. So just a reminder, we are going to be voting tonight by decibel meter. Okay? There it is, the clap-o-meter right there. Make some noise just to see how it works. Well, we may have to adjust. You just pegged it. So that's you're going to be making these votes before the end of the evening. So... I said that was the Messmer 5. It wasn't. It was the Ricci 4 plus Senator Messmer. And but now featuring Mark.
Hey,
Messmer.
Mr. Speaker.
Yeah. Oh gosh. Oh my golly. It's been a rough week. Thank you, Abdul. Ricci's, come back out. Are you still here? Come back this way. Thanks, Abdul. Yeah, well, I don't know, it's going to be tough to roast. Sorry, my mistake. We got to have the judges work you over out here. I was so gotten by your performance. I come out here in front, Campbell. All right, let's see. Let's start with Gabby, the sweet Gabby Gonzalez.
Okay, well, you have a very impressive family. My family can barely sing happy birthday together, so that was great. Also into the coordinating outfits. You got the color scheme going there, so thumbs up from me.
All right, Abdul?
No, I thought you guys were great. I thought you were awesome. I thought the song was extremely relaxing, very mellow. The only thing I was missing was a product I can't get here in Indiana, but there is a summer study committee coming. So, thank you.
Simon?
Well, I was kind of focused on Senator Messmer there. I don't know if the rest of you caught it. That was a really nice bass line. I'm impressed that he finds a new instrument to play every year, a new act to take part in, stopping at nothing in an effort to win this contest.
He's not done yet, by the way.
Yeah, better luck next year.
Okay.
He is a mesmerizing bass player. I mean.
Ooh. All right, here, give it up for the Ricci 4 plus Messmer. All right, we've made fun of Mark already. He's going to take center stage. Mark is a talented musician, obviously. He's going to be joined by Joey Fox on the piano. So, I'm sorry, Mark Webb. Joey's on the program like four or five times also. So, Mark Webb, I'm sorry, Mark, on the piano. Come on out, guys. Give it up for Mark Messmer and Mark Webb.
Okay, well, I'll start with a little background on this song. This is a song, if you've ever been to a Chris Botti concert, famous trumpet player, he ends all of his concerts with "Time to Say Goodbye." And I've taken our family to see several Chris Botti concerts, and it's my daughter's favorite song of all time. When she was, anytime we're in the vehicle traveling, she says, "Dad, put in Time to Say Goodbye." We were leaving for her trip to foreign exchange program a few summers ago, driving to the airport, we played Time to Say Goodbye. And last year at her wedding, I surprised her by playing this song during her wedding mass, so.
All right, that was a crowd pleaser. Awesome. So you played this at your daughter's wedding. All right, so ladies, I just want you to think about this for a second. It's your wedding, and your dad gets up to play the trumpet. What did she have to say?
She cried. And I cried.
In joy or something else?
Perfect joy, yeah.
That's great. Mark, Joey Fox, I thought you were a lot younger man.
Gee, thanks.
Sorry, Mark. All right, judges, what say you? Let's start with Abdul.
Well, Mark, you must really want to be pro tem, dude. You're up there twice.
Yes, go.
No, I know. I thought you were really good. And had I known that Mark played the piano, dude, you're amazing. We will definitely go do the strip club trip together now. So just letting you know.
We're on.
No, keep your clothes on. We're off to the strip club. There you go.
All right, Gabby.
How many instruments do you play? Back-to-back performances? I got to know.
A couple more. We'll save those for another year.
Okay, cool.
Four in public.
Wow.
So when you say four in public, how many total?
I can plunk through the piano, but only the kids and my wife get to hear that ever, that tragedy.
So which four?
Trumpet, acoustic bass, electric bass, and acoustic guitar.
Putting me to shame. Well,
my mom would be ashamed right now.
You were tugging at the heartstrings with the story about your daughter. I could kind of picture that as you were performing. Just amazing skills, great performance for sure.
All right, Jim?
Yeah, I was crying too.
Yeah, we could see you from up here.
Nothing there to criticize. I would simply say that he too is better than Borders.
So this is mostly about Bruce Borders with you, Jim, right? Okay. Okay. Hey, give it up for Mark and Mark, two great musicians.
Yeah.
All right. The next performer is, he's such a quiet guy. I didn't know much about him when he was first elected to the State House, and I didn't know what to think about, honestly. And the more I've gotten to know him, the deeper person I realize that he is. He's an extremely talented musician. He's a man of his own making. And but unfortunately, not by him, but I was told by others that his wife actually selected this. So he's not totally a man of his own making. So Representative Randy Lyness and Ray Stevens, Mississippi Squirrel. Mississippi Squirrel Revival. How could I not remember that? Okay. Randy Lyness, give it up.
Thank you. Hey, can we... What I want to do before I start, and I came here 3 years ago, and I had an L.A. assigned to me. Her name was Brittany McMurray. It's now Brittany Jenkins, and I found out it is her birthday. So what I would like to do, if you would all help me... Brittany, where are you? Back there. Will we all sing happy birthday to Brittany? I'll start it. Stand up, Brittany. Stand up. Okay. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Brittany. Happy birthday to you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Now we'll try this. I decided to come at this a little different this year. Well, when I was a kid, I'd take a trip every summer down to Mississippi, visit my granny in her antebellum world. I'd run barefooted all day long, climbing trees, free as a song, and one day I happened to catch myself a squirrel. So I throwed him down in an old shoebox, and I punched a couple holes in the top, and when Sunday came, well, I snuck him into church. I was sitting way back in the very last pews, showing him to my good buddy Hugh, when that squirrel got loose and went totally berserk. Well, what happened next? That's hard to tell. Some thought it was heaven, others thought it was hell. But the fact that someone was among us was plain to see. As the choir sang, I surrender all. The squirrel ran up Harv Newman's coverall. Harv leaped to his feet and said, something's got a hold on me. Yeah! The day the squirrel went berserk in the first self-righteous church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping views, shouting hallelujah. Well, Harv hit the aisles, dancing and screaming. Some thought he had religion, others thought he had a demon. Harv thought he had a weed eater loose in his fruit of the looms. As he fell to his knees, the pleading begged, the squirrel ran out of his britches and legs, unobserved, to the other side of the room. All the way back to the amen pew, where sat Sister Bertha Better Than You, who was watching all this commotion with sadistic glee. Shoot! You should have seen that look in her eye when that squirrel jumped the garters and crossed her thigh. She leaped to her feet and said, Lord, have mercy on me! As the squirrel made laps inside her dress, she began to cry and then to confess the sins that would make a sailor blush with shame. Well, she talked of gossip and church dissension, but the thing that got the most attention when she talked about her love life, then she started naming names. The day the squirrel went berserk in the first self-righteous church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews, shouting hallelujah. Well, seven deacons and the pastor got saved, and $25,000 got raised, and 50 volunteered for missions in the Congo on the spot. And even without an invitation, there was at least 500 rededications, and we all got rebaptized, whether we needed it or not. Well, you've heard the Bible story, I guess, how he parted the waters for Moses' past. Oh, the miracles God has wrought in this old world. But the one I'll remember to my dying day is how he put that church back on the narrow way with a half-crazed Mississippi squirrel. The day the squirrel went berserk in the first self-righteous church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews, shouting self-righteous church in that sleepy little town at the Gula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews, shouting
I didn't hear any of that because I was working with the next act. What'd you sing?
Mississippi Squirrel Revival.
So what part does the squirrel play in all this?
He's a star.
So exactly when, and I know your wife, I have to tell you, what's your wife's name?
Linda.
He did not tell me this. Actually, he asked me not to say it, and I'm so sorry, but Steve McCaffrey, somebody up at the head table told me that you picked this. So does your wife pick your bow ties every day?
Not every day.
So Randy, you are such a talented, talented musician, seriously. And so tell us a little bit about how you got started in all this.
They used to make me sing before they'd feed me. And that's the truth. That's the truth.
When you say that, are you talking about a cult or your family?
My mother.
My mother. Okay. All right. So, and you're a talented piano player. You sang without it today, but you're really super talented. And so when did that start?
I think I saw where I was 7 years old when I started piano lessons.
So that's great. All right, judges, let's start with the negative, Jim Shella. I'm sorry.
Wait.
Let's start with Jim Shella.
Not necessarily negative. I thought that was very entertaining. I thought it was a big improvement on your gridiron performance. And since this is a fundraiser for Mental Health America, I, for one, give you bonus points for finding a song about someone or something that went berserk.
Thank you.
All right, Abdul,
Actually, Randy's going to surprise you. From my FM disc jockey days, a long, long time ago in a galaxy far, far away, I'm quite familiar with Ray Stevens' work, and thank you for not doing the streak.
The night's not over, by the way. Gabby?
You had the audience participation right off the bat, birthday shout-outs, people were clapping over here, even up there they were dancing. And, yeah, and Abdul was singing along, so I think that's a success.
All right, give it up for Randy Lyness. All right, come on out, Melanie Wright and the House Democrat interns. I don't know if you know this, but Melanie Wright's a teacher. I'm getting no laughs from anybody in the... Melanie Wright's a teacher. She's one of the few teachers in the General Assembly. So she's going to do a little teaching. She's going to organize this fantastic group in who knows what. We've seen all kinds of things over the last few years in Can't Stop the Feeling. And I want to tell you that the best part of this is that Dr. Vernon Smith, Justin Moed, and Aunt Delaney are not up here this year. All right, give it up for Melanie Wright and Can't Stop the Feeling.
Hey, everybody. We're going to do a little audience participation this year. So in the middle of the song, you're going to hear the part that connects the beginning to the end. It's called The Bridge. It has music, but no lyrics. So we're going to divide the room into three groups. So this part over here, you're going to be group one, and this is what you're going to do. On the even count, you're going to clap for one set of eight. So you're going to go.
Good luck.
Ready?
With that.
And. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Very good. Let's try it one more time. 5, 6, 7, 8. You got it. All right. Middle group. Group number two. You're going to do what I call fireworks. You're going to start to your right. You're going to go. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right. So let's see all the middle group. 5, 6. Ready? Go to your right. Right. Hey, that's awesome. All right. Group three. You're going to raise the roof. So you're going to go up on one, up on the odds, down on the evens. So it's going to look like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. Let's try it one more time. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, the fourth time through, you're all going to do your parts at the same time. So you guys will do the claps on the evens. You guys will do the fireworks starting on the right. You guys will do the raise the roof going up on the odds, down on the evens. So let's try the fourth time through. 5, 6, ready, go. Very good. Now, over here, you're going to follow these interns over here. Middle people, you're going to follow us. And then group three, you're going to follow this group. Let's try it one more time. Let's do group one, group two, group three, and then together. All right, here we go. Group one. 5, 6, 7, 8. 5, 6, everybody. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Well,
you are on it.
Remember the old jazz or something?
Now, I'll cue you when we get there. Thank you.
That's what I do now.
All right.
Oh, yeah, this is going to be good. I need another drink. Oops, sorry, that thing is on. Is this thing on?
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. I got that sunshine in my pocket. Got that good soul in my feet. I feel that hot blood in my body when it drops. Ooh, I can't take my eyes off of it. Moving so phenomenally. Come on, lock the way we rock it. So don't stop. And under the lights when everything goes. Nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know. So just imagine. But you, when you dance, 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 feel a good, good creeping up on you. So just dance, dance, dance.
dancing, so keep dancing. I can't stop the feeling. So just dance, dance, dance. I can't stop the feeling. So just dance, dance, dance. I can't stop the feeling. So just dance.
Give it up for Melanie and the Can't Stop This Feeling. Woo! All right, don't leave. Come out here. Come out here, kids. Don't leave. All right. You got some skills.
Woo!
So these are self-developed?
No, I danced my whole life.
Yeah, I figured so. Are you acutely aware that you're the only male out here?
Yeah, sadly.
So what do you have to say about that?
Hey, I'm just glad to represent out here, though.
All right. Woo-hoo! All right, so I got a quick question. Did these kids practice this on state time? Don't answer that. Just asking. All right, Melanie, you do such a great job of organizing your interns to do something like this, and I was watching from back here. Several of you got some really great skills. A couple of you. Woo. I'm just joking. You're all great. All right, judges, what do you have to say? Gabby?
You know, I skipped the gym today, but I felt like I was at a Zumba class. We had the counts down. Everybody was with it. I loved it. And the little solo there in mid-performance, excellent stuff. So I was all about it. And I also am a big fan of Justin Timberlake, so perfect.
All right, Jim. Abdul?
Jim,
go ahead.
Mel, I got to give you points for that. You got a real, Robert Preston Music Man thing working there. Good thing these interns are new every year. I just wish the crowd had caught up with you at some point.
Abdul?
Well, Melanie, as always, you do a really great job. Your interns do a really great job. And, hell, one more intern, you could have had Senate Democrats up there. I'm just saying.
Give it up for Melanie Wright and Can't Stop the Feeling. All right, we have a special treat tonight, a repeat performer. We had the Secretary of FSSA, Dr. Jennifer Walthall, with us last year, a very talented vocalist. And she's back, and she's got a backup group that includes Dr. Charles Maramonte, Joey Fox, and Dr. Walthall's son, Joey. And this is a song that Jennifer and Charlie wrote. So give it up for Jennifer Walthall and the team.
This year, I think I turned 54 instead of 44. But if I were to add a decade of work into 1 year, it would have been this one. So to support the lives of many battling things that most of us will never understand, we throw back to the songwriting days of Jen and Charlie, circa 2003, 9 children ago, and a life of promise ahead.
Here you go, guys. Don't dream it's over. Where would you go? Where would you turn? Where would you fly from here? How hard would you try? How hard would you fight? How hard would you try and stay? And the world, you see, never made much sense to me. And all my dreams seem so faded. Thought I always had to doubt it. Guess I'm gonna have to live without it. Still you look at me so frustrated. Then you'd say, pull me closer, I'll be the one to wash away your sins of treason. Hold me down now with all of your weight. I'll weather all your changing seasons. Where would you go? Where would you turn? Where would you look for change? How hard would you try? How hard would you fight? Who's gonna look inside of me? And the world, you see, never made much sense to me. And all my dreams seem so faded. Thought I always had to doubt it. Guess I'm gonna have to live without it. Still you'd look at me so frustrated. Then you'd say, pull me closer, I'll be the one to wash away your sins of treason. Hold me down now with all of your weight. I'll weather all your changing seasons. There is freedom within, there is freedom without. Try to catch the deluge in a paper cup. There's a battle ahead, many battles are lost, but you'll never see the end of the road while you're traveling with me. Hey now, don't dream it's over. Hey now, when the world comes in, they've come to build a wall between us. You know that they won't win. Now I'm walking ahead to the beat of a drum, and I'm counting the steps to the door of your heart. There are shadows ahead, barely clearing the roof, but you'll never see the end of the road while you're traveling with me. Hey now, don't dream it's over. Hey now, when the world comes in, they've come to build a wall between us. You know that they won't win. And the world to see never made much sense to me. And all my dreams seem so faded. Thought I always had to doubt it. Guess I'm gonna have to live without it. Still you'd look at me so frustrated. Then you'd say, pull me closer, I'll be the one to wash away your sins of treason. Hold me down now with all of your weight. Weather all your changing seasons. Where would you go? Where would you turn? Where would you look for change?
Give it up for Dr. Jennifer Walthall and the team. Come on out, guys. All right. So, Dr. Walthall, you're in a critical position, but many people don't know you. So I know you were the chief of pediatric medicine at IU. And so just tell us a little bit about yourself and how you got to the position you're in at FSSA.
I have no idea.
Okay. Well, that's the same for a lot of us. You're confirming our position. So what's the story on your talented voice?
So I started singing in church at age 5. And then picked up and sang in musicals all through high school and college. And then Charlie and I met our first day of residency, and we sang in little tiny coffee shops all over Indianapolis and wrote music for a long time. And then we realized we weren't actually very good at it. And and so we went on to other careers, which was a really, really good plan.
All right, Charlie, so what's your program?
Program.
You're just a guitar player, that's it?
That's it. That's all I do. I play guitar, a little bit of axe, that's it. I got nothing.
Wow. And just the drums?
Yes.
You guys are giving me no material here. And the bass, you've just been playing that for?
Cello.
The cello, actually.
Cello, yeah, that's it.
Little teeny tiny bass. Yeah, I see it now. I gotta look at it. Is your name Yo-Yo Ma? Hi, are you Mark Webb?
I'm just a lowly lobbyist from Egypt.
Yeah, I know you. I went to high school with your mom. All right, come out here, Jennifer. I really did go to high school with his mom. Come out, Jennifer. All right, let's start with Abdul.
Dr. Walthall, you did it to me again. Just like you're ready to write about FSA, you do a kick-ass song with Crowded House from high school. Damn it, you did it to me again. Thank you.
Gabby.
Yeah, I'm into the whole mashup situation. You were just taking over the stage. Great presence up there. So, awesome job.
Simon.
Well, let me just share, Doctor, that I sang in church as a child, too.
What church, Jim?
It was the Jasper American Lutheran Church in Jasper, Minnesota. And every Sunday I would line
Somebody
up.
Somebody Google that real quick for me.
Every Sunday I would line up for the processional, and the choir director would come back to me and say, just mouth the words this time. She never would have done that to you. I was impressed.
All right. Give it up for Jennifer Walthall and the team here. Okay, we have a couple of, this is a formidable crew because we have a couple of former Hoosier Idol winners that have teamed up. I was walking by, on the fourth floor, there's a chapel. I know most of you don't know where that is. in my position, you got to pray every once in a while. So there is a chapel upstairs, and I was walking by the other day, and I heard this melodic voices coming out, and I opened the door, and there was Senator Erin Houchin, John Coppin singing. And that's where they've been practicing. So I think they've got a little extra edge here, if you know what I mean. So we have Senator Houchin, John Coppin, accompanied by Joey Fox and Kathy Davis. Give it up, folks.
Now I've heard there was a secret chord that David played, and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do ya? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composed.
Faith was strong, but I needed proof. Saw her bathing on the roof. Her beauty in the moonlight overthrew ya. She tied you to a kitchen chair. She broke your throne, she cut your hair. And from your lips she drew the hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Here before, I've seen this room, I've walked this floor. I used to live alone before I knew ya. I've seen your flag on the marble arch, and love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. It wasn't much, I couldn't feel, so I tried to touch. I told the truth, I didn't come to fool ya. And even though it all went wrong, I'll stand before the Lord of Song with nothing on my tongue but hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Wow. So I told you this was difficult this year because everyone's so talented. You usually have some people that are kind of marginal and you can give them a hard time. Come here, John. So I'm going to have to resort to little-known facts. Two little-known facts. One, Erin Houchin was actually my legislative assistant for 3 weeks.
You're welcome.
And she quit.
I did really good work.
I didn't meet her. I met her once, and then she took a job at the Senate, and that is not a joke. That's an absolute true deal. And when Cheryl and I first started making the rounds in politics in Marion County, which is a very difficult place for 26-year-old people to start walking around, John's mom and dad were like our parents in Lawrence Township and were dear supporters. And I mean, I can only say thank you. I know they're both gone, but they were wonderful people and just great friends. And we've all had that. You had somebody that helped you out along the way, right? And didn't need to. They didn't get anything out of it, but they kind of saw something in you. And
they loved you all very much.
Yeah, they were great, great people. All right, judges, what do you have to say to this fantastic, by the way, hallelujah, Jim Shella?
Well, if there's any criticism to be made, it's that this stuff is way too highbrow for this audience. A violin? Holy cats.
Yeah, Kathy, you are fantastic back there. Gabby? Yeah. Give it up for Kathy. And Joey? You're fantastic. And I really did go to high school with his mom. Gabby?
You guys are bringing it. I mean, everyone tonight has been excellent, but to have two former winners join forces, the competition is tough. Amazing job.
Abdul?
I am amazed that in a building full of people who are so talented and so good at what they do, it took them so long to figure out Sunday sales.
So one more thing, John, I know, and I knew you for years, and then I attended some association luncheon, and you sang the national anthem, and I'm literally standing there bawling. I had no idea, and subsequently found out you were trained vocalist at IU, right?
Right, yeah, IU.
Yeah. And Erin, your voice is awesome, and what kind of formal training have you had, or are you self-trained?
I have no formal training. I sang in a bar at karaoke, and somebody said, hey, you're a pretty good singer. So I took it from there.
So bar karaoke, folks. That's the key to success. Give it up for Erin and John, Joey and Kathy. All right, I've lost my script, Steve. But I believe now is the time when we bring everyone out. Is that correct? Give me a hint. Everybody comes back. Okay, don't forget, we've got the decibel meter. Give it a shot. Clap-o-meter. Give it a... Come on, do it. You got horns there. Let's see it. Wow, that's really lame. Is that for me? Oh, now you're pegging. Now you're pegging. All right, let's get all the acts up here.
I'm trying to think. Well, Melanie's... That's out.
All right, not very organized. Come on out here, guys. So first act over here, like I'm going to remember the order. All right, the decibel, very scientific. This is extremely scientific. Do you understand this? I mean, engineers have been working around the clock for thousands of hours to come up with this decibel meter. I mean, seriously, it is very scientific. So let me get behind these people because you want to see them, not me. So Give it up for the Ricci Five. All right. Lyness and Webb. I'm sorry. I'm mixing folks up. The Marks. Messmer and Webb. The Lyness Meter. All right, I can't get behind this group. Melanie Wright and Can't Stop the Feeling. Woo! The Jennifer Walthall Quartet. I hope somebody else is looking at this because I can't do this and look at the same time. Okay, wait. Hold on. Okay, now. Okay, Joey, you got to pick a group. All right, Campbell and Houchin. All right, did it look like Houchin and Lyness to y'all? No? So I need, judges, what did you see?
That's what I saw.
Houchin and Lyness? All right, Gabby?
I agree, yep.
Yep, Abdul? Okay, so congratulations to everyone else. We really, really, honestly, there's very little material because everybody was great. We want some crummy acts. Matt Whetstone, where are you?
Where's
Bring back the soggy bottom boys. It's something to laugh at. All right,
hey, Brian,
thank you so much.
Can you bring Bruce Borders back?
I got nothing there. All right, so we're going to leave Randy Lyness and the Houchin and Coppin group out here for the finals. All right, you ready? This is it. We're down to two finalists. Randy Lyness. Houchin and Coppin.
They buried it.
That's tight.
They buried it. Nice.
Judges.
I say it went to Houchin and Coppin.
That's what I thought, too.
Houchin.
Randy, you were fantastic. Thank you for sharing your talents with us tonight. Congratulations, Senator Houchin, John, Joey, Kathy. Thank you so much. Just because you're a lobbyist, you don't have to walk away. You won.
Get in here, guys.
I'm presuming your pictures are done by now. So there's, don't leave yet, because there's one more act. Several members that are out here, several folks, were at a lounge recently, and they saw a lounge singer that had to come here tonight and sing. So, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for, where are you? I don't see you. Let me come out and introduce him. His tie's off, his pocket square is still there. Give it up, ladies and gentlemen, for our Attorney General.
There are girls just ripe for some kissing, and I mean to kiss me a few. Oh, those girls don't know what they're missing. I've got a lot. lot of living to do. And there's wine already for tasting, and there's Cadillacs all shiny and new. Gotta move, 'cause time is a waste, and there's such a lot of living to do. There's music to play, places to go, and people to see. Everything for you and me. Life's a ball, if only you know it, and it's all waiting for you. Come alive, oh, go out and show it. There's such a lot of living to do. Living to do. There's such a lot of living to do. There's music to play, places to go, and people to see. Everything for you and me. Life's a ball, if only you know it, and it's all just waiting for you. Come alive, oh, go out and show it. There's such a lot of living, such a lot of living, such a lot.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Attorney General Curtis Hill, Sammy Davis. And one other final round of applause. How about let's hear it for our MC tonight, Mr. Speaker Brian Bosma. Nice pageant wave there. Thank you all very much for joining us tonight. We're greatly appreciative of your support of Mental Health America of Indiana. Please be safe and careful driving home. We'll see you again next year. Have a good night.